So most people who look and try to find information about diabetes ask themselves a really straightforward question early on, which is, what are the symptoms of diabetes? If you have an interest in diabetes and you want to keep up to date, then subscribe, share, comment, and like this page. So we're going to look at symptoms and we're going to compare that to blood sugar levels. And the first thing you'll notice is that as the blood sugar levels rise, the symptoms actually increase very slowly. But at a certain point, they seem to go up really quite dramatically. And so for most people that are initially diagnosed, in fact, they have no symptoms at all. Most people with abnormal sugars, but relatively low levels, feel fine. If you then expand that further and the blood sugars go up a little bit, then what you find is people then start talking about fatigue. And that's the most common, real, true symptom of diabetes. And if sugars go further and up higher, then not only do we start seeing fatigue, but also increasing urination. So they get up two or three times a night, three, four, five times a night to pass urine. And when the blood sugars become elevated and become elevated above, say, around about 10 or millimoles per liter or 180 milligrams per deciliter, then we start seeing impairment in the way that the immune system functions and infections become more common. And that may be things like skin wounds that don't heal and cuts and braises that really struggle to heal. Or it could be something like urinary or chest infections, something that you wouldn't necessarily think of as being related to diabetes, but it certainly is. So when the sugars go up even higher, that's when we start to see excessive thirst. So if you're passing a lot of urine, you start to feel very thirsty. And often people in that situation will do something that is actually quite illogical, but makes total sense, which is they will consume lots and lots of sugary drinks. Even though the blood sugars are high, because you're losing a lot of sugar in your urine, the body has this sort of compulsion to find sugary sweet things. So not only will people in this situation be looking for sugary drinks, they tend to consume lots of things like fruit juice and soft drinks. And that causes the blood sugars to go even higher. And so that's when you see really the main symptoms that you would see described in books and on websites of fatigue, urination, excessive thirst, and blurred vision. Now blurred vision is quite an interesting thing. What happens in that situation is that the sugar actually impregnates into the lens of the eye and causes it to swell. And it effectively is changing people's magnification and their ability to see. And over the years, I've seen so many people who've gone to the optometrist who've been told they need glasses, been given brand new glasses, and then we discover they have diabetes, change their blood sugars over time, the lens shape changes, and then it turns out they never needed glasses whatsoever. So all of those are the symptoms of diabetes, and they all occur based on the blood sugar level. Now, how long does that take to occur? How quickly does someone go from having no symptoms at all to having lots? Well, it depends on the kind of diabetes you have. So if you take someone with type 2 diabetes, we know that most people, when they're diagnosed, have already had type 2 diabetes for anywhere from 5 to 10 years prior to diagnosis. And often what happens is a person will have diabetes, but then prior to that, they'll have borderline diabetes or pre-diabetes. And before that, they'll have abnormal insulin reactions to their glucose. So it's a slow and steady progression that occurs over time. If you found this video helpful, then please subscribe to the channel so that I can keep you up to date as all the new videos come online.